Ooh, all right. What can I say? Dude. Chris Paul to the Warriors? Are you serious right now? Everybody thought he was going to the Lakers or somewhere else. He got traded to the Wizards, and I didn't even know that, to be honest. But now he's about to go to the Warriors? Like, Curry? Like, I just never thought Chris Paul, all the rivalries they had together, I just never thought there would be, a team, a teammate stuff, but I'm about to see what this is all about, bro. This is crazy.
We have some monster breaking news, including a future Hall of Famer, Adrian Wojnarowski, still on the desk with us. What more can you tell us?
Yeah, Cassidy, a big one. The Washington Wizards have agreed to send Chris Paul to the Golden State Warriors for Jordan Poole and two future draft picks.
How stupid can the Wizards be? I mean, Jordan Poole is a good player, but when he got that money, he fell off. And they got Chris Paul. I mean, y'all, we already knew that Chris Paul was not going to stay in the Wizards, but you know. And Jordan Poole, like, that's not, you can't even compare those two, bro. Like, this is crazy. Like, you.
With the Phoenix Suns, the Wizards have been looking for a situation to move Chris Paul onto. And now the Warriors step in, bring in Chris Paul to play with Klay Thompson, obviously Steph Curry.
Chris Paul, he's coming off the bench, no doubt. Because you can't have Chris Paul and Curry playing at the same time.
This is a Warriors team that has some difficult financial decisions to make.
Difficult. You gave this guy too much money. And he flopped. Yeah, that's a difficult financial. Yeah, whatever. They just gotta handle their money right. Hopefully, that guy Dunleavy, whatever his name is, that used to play basketball, can. He's the general manager now. He can help him.
And now Chris Paul, who wanted to play very much for a contender, his conversations with the Wizards, Michael Winger, their president, his agent, Stephen Heumann, they've been working all week to try to find a landing spot for Chris Paul. And it is the Warriors who now bring in this future Hall of Fame player as they try to maximize this window with Steph Curry.
They're trying to get another ring, fam. I thought this guy would go to the Lakers.
Gathering up picks, gathering up young assets, and they're really in a full rebuild now.
Okay, Woj, whatever. Let's just say this. Chris Paul is one of the best point guards, one of the best point guards of all time. Okay, that's hands down, no conversation. But dang, you put him together with Stephen Curry as one of the best point guards. I just don't want to see that, how that clicks together. Like, you have two point guards, like, on the same team. Like, it's just, I don't know, I just don't want this to flop. I want this to be a rivalry with somebody. But if this flops, I would not be surprised because, Russell Westbrook and LeBron, I mean, no, that wouldn't, but. Oh, I just don't understand. I don't understand. Exactly.
Circumstances around that, certainly at the beginning of the year, and all that he went through with Draymond Green and the punch.
Yes, we gotta talk about the punch. The punch is what set everything apart. The Warriors was destined for downhill ever since that punch. It was a punch heard around the world. Because once that punch was thrown, I mean, it was all, chaos, drama. They couldn't even get it together. They went to the playoffs, lost to the Lakers, that nobody even thought the Lakers would be in the playoffs. I mean, we all knew that it was going to fall off ever since, that punch. But to see that, Draymond is, looking for, he denied his offer. I mean, he might try to get some more money. You never know. But see Jordan Poole leave, we all knew that was coming. I mean, just for that punch, and, you know, just...
I'm not sleeping on this.
But, you know, it is what it is. You know?
This is a play for this organization with Chris Paul, who's owed $30 million this year. This is an expiring deal for the Warriors. It gives them a chance to bring a player who... And Chris Paul, you are not asking him to carry a significant big role. There's
exactly.
plenty of great guard play here, but certainly the role he can play could be significant as they try to get back into championship contention. And, you know, Mike Dunleavy Jr., Joe Lacob, their owner, you know, they've talked about
off the bench.
Compete, but also the reality that with this new salary cap, with the payroll that has to eventually get raised.
Payroll.
4 years, $140 million.
Bro, it is such a freaking money business. People want their money, and if they don't, they got some problems. Like, money can change your mind so much, but, you know, Chris Paul's not like that guy. He just wants his ring. I mean, he's too old to not have a ring yet. I mean, sadly, Carmelo Anthony did not get a ring, you know, shout out to him. But, you know, it's such a business, man. Like, you got, compared to the 90s, compared to now, it is like, bro, Jordan got $90 million his whole NBA career. And now someone that's not even the best player in the world can easily get that in like 3 years. Brother.
In Golden State, and part of what you see why draft picks going back to Washington in this is that kind of money. You saw it with Bradley Beal. This is a different time in the NBA with big contracts. And so the Warriors almost had to incentivize that a little bit in getting off that much money.
And Perk, Chris Paul, 38, turns 39 next May. Talking about just the type of role that he could play with this Warriors team. What do you envision that he could do with Golden State?
He's going to fit in just fine. The one thing that we saw over the last couple of years is that Chris Paul has shown us that he can actually play off the ball and be a capable knockdown three-point shooter. But I want to go back to Jordan Poole for a second. We saw the writing on the wall. We saw at times when Steph Curry was frustrated with him when he was...
Bro. That just reminded me, bro. Do y'all remember that picture that that they took after they lost against the Lakers? Like, they lose to the Lakers in, you know, game 6. And Stephen Curry's like this, Olympia's like this. I'm looking at Jordan Poole. For he right in that moment, I knew Jordan Poole was not going to stay. I mean, he was looking like, I'm going to kill this bastard. I'm going to bury him and dance on his grave. Like, that. He wanted him going, like, in that series. Because that guy averaged, like, 3 points per game and got all that money, dude. You can't do that. So, I know Stephen Curry, you know, like, Kirk. You know, Perk said he was frustrated.
That Steph should have felt like that the Golden State Warriors felt like should have been in Steph's hands. We seen and we heard Draymond Green talk about how that incident basically broke up their locker room and they weren't going to win a championship. We saw the drop off. And the great Kevin Garnett used to always say, watch the young players after they get their money. And that's how you can see the real them. And to be honest, since Jordan Poole got the bag, he's been a completely different player.
Exactly. The bag changes the player. Change the personality and change the game.
$128 million.
More than Jordan. More than Michael Jordan in his whole career. Crazy. It's crazy out here, bro. It's crazy.
I don't think that that's a great indicator. I will say this about Jordan Poole and about a lot of young players.
Richard.
If you're in a great situation and you have to recognize that very quickly you can end up on the Washington Wizards, no disrespect to them, in a rebuild space. So you can go.
But that's disrespectful. Don't mean act like it's not disrespectful.
You're not going to be on TV. You're going to be a part of a rebuild. Or you can fix your face. You can fix your attitude and get back in line and compete for championships. So I think, you know, while this is unfortunate.
Bro, these niggas are cutting grass. Like, bro, you're so loud. Why are you cutting? You're not even. Ugh, it's irritating. Anyway.
you know, that they had to break up part of their young core. There were some money incentives on it. But ultimately, Chris Paul to the Warriors, I think that that is a great move for Chris Paul.
But I want to, I want to clarify what I'm trying to explain to you so you can actually listen.
He said, I want to clarify. This guy here.
We saw the frustration with the shot selection he was taking. It had nothing to do with him getting punched. It's everything about him saying, I got my
back, so it kind of is. The punch did something. Okay, buddy.
I mean, you can go take it over KG. I'm just telling you what he told me, and that's what I said. That's an all-time break.
Deal 9 minutes, kind of.
Yeah, listen, in this league, the only thing you are guaranteed is the money.
Why did Perk look back at him like that? But anyway, okay, they can keep talking about, you know, little stats and all this. I don't care about that. It's just how this happened out of nowhere, in the middle of the day. Everybody's minding their own business, and then boom, the Wizards finalize a deal with Chris Paul to go to the Warriors. And I never would have thought that Chris Paul would go to the Warriors, and here he is now, and going to the next season. That's going to be interesting. So, Lakers didn't get Chris Paul. Like always, Lakers can't pick nobody up. So, it is what it is. I'm going to see how that's going to work out. Stephen Curry and Chris Paul. I wonder if Chris Paul and Stephen Curry can be on the court at the same time. Or, you know, they switch and everything. But, for Jordan Poole, it was coming to you, buddy. After all that, you know, 3 points per game in the playoffs, all of that stuff that happened, we all knew that it was going downhill, and he wasn't going to stay with the Warriors. They gave him all that money for nothing. So that 4 years is going to the Wizards. They're going to have to change it up a little bit probably. And hopefully he can, you know, do something with Kyle Kuzma because he's over there, and he's been balling out and crazy. You know, he's free. So Jordan Poole will be probably free if he could, but if he doesn't, yeah, I wouldn't be surprised. But that's what I got to say about that one. Like this video and subscribe to my channel if you want more of this. And that's all I gotta say about it. I'm out.